Death doesn't leave scars.
Hello everyone, how's it going, and welcome back to today's Wild Rift video. Today's video, we're going to be taking a deeper dive look at Senna. Now with Senna in the Horizon Cup, we kind of saw two different types of builds with her. We saw a more damage sort of build, and we saw a more utility sort of support build as well. But the most important thing before we get into this video is that with Senna, you don't actually want to take any minions. Whether you play her in the dragon lane or whether you play her in the support role, you don't ever want to take any minions. And the most important thing to note about that is that you want to make sure you get as many souls as possible. Now, a few patches ago, they kind of reduced the drop rate of the souls quite a lot when you last hit minions. So obviously, when you last hit minions, you're going to be getting a lot of gold, but you're not going to be getting a lot of souls. And the way Senna, you know, stacks up and the way Senna kind of scales into late game is being able to collect as many souls as possible. So what do you actually play Senna with down in the bot lane then as a dragon laner? Well, you mainly play her with like tank sort of champions. So Galio, Gragas, Wukong are very, very good, but it's what we call Fasting Senna. Now, Fasting Senna means that the tank, so your kind of support in a way, is going to be taking all the CS and going to be building just pure tank. So Gragas, Wukong, Galio is going to be taking all the farm and just going to be building pure tank. And obviously you will be dealing damage with your build, but you'll just be collecting souls the whole time by poking down the enemy champions and by collecting souls from the ground. So with that in mind, you need to make sure obviously you don't last hit any CS, but this is what they call Fasting Senna. So you want to make sure that you kind of have a duo partner with you, because this won't work a lot in solo queue. So going through the build, you got Mana Immune as your first item. Very, very good item for Senna, as you will be poking, as I said, down enemy champions a lot. So you will be using your abilities a lot, and this will just give you a lot of damage. And then after that, you just want to kind of just build as much damage as possible. You got items like Ghost Blade, Serrator's Grudge, Rapid Fire Cannon for the range and crit as well. And you even have Guardian Angel as your last item as well, just to kind of keep you alive. But with this build, you're going to be doing a lot of damage. You're going to be attacking from range as well. You're going to be doing critical strike damage as well. And overall, this build is just going to be very, very strong. Now, moving on to the support sort of orientated build, as you can see, there's not a lot of damage in this build. This is more to do with utility and more to do with kind of helping your team out in terms of armor penetration, whether it be the slows or anything like that as well. Now, this is just your standard support Senna build. You don't need to do anything crazy. You got your AD carry with you. You got your support Senna with you as well, and you'll be completely fine. So you got items like Iceborne Gauntlet, which will make you a bit tanky, give you a lot of mana, give you that slow as well. Again, Black Cleaver giving you that little bit of damage, but making sure you get really, really tanky. Rapid Fire Cannon for the range. Mortar Reminder for the healing reduction as well, and just a little bit of extra damage. And as always, Guardian Angel as your last item as well. Now, in terms of boots with Senna, you can go for the Lucidity boots if you want to, but you can go for other sort of boots as well. You can go for the Plated Steel Caps is a good option. Mercury Treads is also a good option as well. And in terms of boots upgrades, Stasis is a good option if you do want to play really, really defensive. You can go for Redemption if you're going for that more support-orientated build, if you want to go for Redemption. But most of the time, you just want to go for Stasis to kind of keep yourself alive, because even though you are going to be building that support Senna build, or even if you build the AD sort of Senna build, you will still be really, really squishy, and you will still be very, very easy target for the enemy champions and the assassins in particular. In terms of the runes, you're grasping, I'm dying. Obviously, as I said, with Senna, you want to be poking down the enemy champions as much as possible. And every 4 seconds in combat, your next attack on a champion will be enhanced based on your maximum health. So you'll be able to heal 2% of your maximum health. You'll be able to permanently increase your health as well by 5. And you'll be able to do bonus damage at the same time as well. So this is very, very helpful with Senna. You also got Brutal for the extra damage early on, the extra AD damage. Bone Plating, which helps you a lot against that combo damage. And you got Sweet Tooth in there as well. And then with the support build, you kind of want to go for something a bit similar. You got Weakness in there, which will help you a lot, especially with the root, especially with your slows as well, because impairing the movement of the enemy champions make them take 5% more damage. So even though you're not doing a lot of damage, you'll be able to deal more damage with the Weakness, and your rest of your team will be able to deal more damage with Weakness as well. Hunter Titan's in there as well. You can go for Hunter Titan if you want to, as a different variant. Hunter Titan gives you that maximum health and gives you Tenacity, so reduces the crowd control of the enemy champions. And also you got Mana Flow Band in there as well. So you don't really want to take Sweet Tooth because most of the time you won't actually be taking the healing at support center. You just want Mana Flow Band in there. Just kind of make sure you get that extra bit of mana just so you're kind of not running out of mana at any point. And for the spells, we have Flash and we have Barrier. You can go for heal if you want to as well. Just kind of depends on what the duo takes down in the bot lane. But yeah, that's pretty much everything to do with Senna. As I said, we saw both variants in the Horizon Cup. Let me know down in the comments what your thoughts are of Senna and what you think of the two builds and kind of what you prefer as well. It'd be very nice to get your opinions as well at the same time. But yeah, as always, enjoy the gameplay that I'm about to show you. Another Fiesta game of good old streamer game, streamer content, as they would say. And yeah, as always, take care of yourselves, and I'll see you all very soon. Peace.
I'll get us through this. The only way out of the mist is through it.